Hello and welcome to the Formula One World Tour 2023. And we are here at Cannes, which is where we're going to start the World Tour. And there's a reason for that. As you can see, we're in a Falcon. It's not the Falcon 900 EX. But this is a Falcon 50 EX. And as you can see by the livery and probably the title by now, for this World Tour, we're going to be Max Verstappen's private pilot. So, I've done a little research on the first event, which is in Bahrain, however you say it. And I found the route that Max Verstappen has taken there this week. So we're going to do that, and should be a few hours flying. It's taken us a very interesting route, one that I've never done before. And we're landing at some very obscure places, which are not obscure, I'm sure you all know them, but places I didn't think that people would stop off at for obvious reasons. So we're going to go from Cannes to Ankara, which is in Turkey, which is it's fine. I mean, it seems like it's a bit of like a countryside sort of area in Turkey. There's not a lot about there. I've certainly never heard of Ankara before. Maybe I'm just ignorant. But so then we're going to go from Ankara into Basra, which is Al-Basra in Iraq. Obviously a place that I didn't think people would be landing, 14 million pound private jets and stuff like that. But I guess you do need to refuel, and maybe the fuel out there is cheap or something. I don't know why they chose that route. I guess it's on the way as well, so that probably helps. And then we're going to go from
East traffic, Canada Air 2582.
Sorry, my bad.
Final approach runway 04 left, 4 miles out. East traffic.
Okay, yep. So as I was saying, and then we're going to do a short hop from Iraq to Bahrain. Should be a nice flight. As you can hear, I'm live on VATSIM, so hopefully get some ATC along the way. I can see across Italy we have quite good coverage right now, so if we can get off in time, we may get some coverage over there. Other than that, might have some control in Turkey. I can see Ankara controls on right now, so if we get to Turkey in time, then maybe we'll have the control there. And there's nothing further than that, so once we get past there, obviously I don't think people in Iraq, Bahrain, nothing down at Bahrain right now, so yeah, mostly through Italy, and then once we get into Turkey we'll have some control, hopefully. But we're still going to do all the call-outs, because we've got quite busy airspace here at Cannes. We're the only people at this airport, but we have a lot of planes going into Nice, Côte d'Azur. But yeah, bigger flights. So I believe Verstappen has boarded. So let's jump in at the close the door, because you do get a bit rowdy on a race weekend. Do like a party back there. And we'll get this thing fired up. So we're going to be using the X checklist. One of those, I prefer transparent one here. And one thing that I have enough fuel. Okay. Okay, get the thing fired up. There we can see. Welcome aboard.
Check. Review. Then continue to performance data.
That's fine. I know all
review,
of the.
Then continue to pre-flight checklist.
I know all of the parameters
chocks
for this.
And covers
plane.
In
I've
place.
Flown this for a long time.
Static elements on.
And let's see if we have all this
set. Start yeah. Exterior inspection.
And we're not going to do that because I've already done that before Verstappen got
complete.
Here.
Complete. Remove chocks and covers.
Just to save a bit of time,
static
obviously.
Static elements off. Checked.
Done that.
Cabin door and main hatch.
Okay, so now we can close the
closed.
Main door.
Everyone's parking brakes. Engaged. Failure warning lights, Reset test switch. Checked.
Yep.
Floor switch, off. Checked.
There.
Audio VHF 1 and 2, pressed.
Good.
Set. Microphone VHF 1 and 2, pressed. Set. Volume knobs, high, full clockwise. Set.
Yep.
Static selector, normal.
Static selector there.
Fire pull handles, 1, 2 and 3 pushed in.
They're in. Yep, oh, you have to do that one
Checked.
Manually.
Fire extinguisher switches 1 to 6, off. Checked.
That's okay.
Landing gear handle, down. Checked. Emergency gear pull handle, in.
In.
Checked. Co-pilot pitot static selector, normal. Checked.
Normal.
Anti-skid, number 1 on. Checked. Hydraulic standby pump, on.
Felix.
Set. Thrust reverser, normal and locked. Checked. Cabin pressure selector, auto and locked. Checked. Cabin manual pressurization, down and hold, set to current altitude. Set. Visual check cabin triple indicator, left hand pilot panel. Checked. Air brake, set to zero. Checked. Power levers, cut off. Checked. Slat flap handle, clean. Checked. Co-pilot floor switch, off. Set.
Yeah.
Conditioning temp controls, auto 10 o'clock. Set. Left hand and right hand bus, tied, horizontal. Checked.
We got it.
Battery 1 and 2, off.
Yeah.
Checked. Generator 1, 2 and 3, on. Checked. Computer 1, 2 and 3, set to auto. Set. Motor 1, 2 and 3, set to ground start.
Yep.
Set. Transfer pumps 1, 2 and 3, off. Checked. Transfer intercom 1 and 2, untied, vertical. Checked. Booster pumps 1, 2 and 3, off. Checked. Crossfeed 1 and 2, untied, vertical.
Yep.
Checked. Pitot pilot and co-pilot, off. Checked. Windshield pilot and co-pilot and side, off. Checked. Bleed air HP 123 and APU, auto. Set. Bleed air isolation, tied, horizontal. Set. Bleed air, cabin and crew, auto. Set. Bleed air bag, on. Set. Anti-ice engine 123 and wings, off. Set.
Lovely.
Battery 1 and 2, on.
Okay, so time to fire it up and get the batteries.
Set. Booster pump 2, on.
And I think we're going to start with the APU. So, booster pump 2.
Set.
There on.
APU master, on. Set. APU start, on. Set.
There we go.
External power, on.
We don't need to do that because we're not using external
Set.
Power.
Brake selector, intermediate indent. Set. External
yep.
lights, to NAB. Set. Fasten seat belts and no smoking, on. Set. Emergency lights, arm. Set. Pilot and co-pilot AV master, overhead, on. Set. Audio VHF 1, pressed. Set. Master warning and master caution. Reset. Fuel, refuel as necessary, 40% minimum. Checked. Fuel used counter, reset. Set. Hydraulic standby pump, auto. Set. Slat system stall 2 test, press.
This might be a bit loud, sorry guys.
IRS, align.
Quite loud.
Set. Barometric value, local QNH. Set.
Yeah, so let's
file flight plan with ATC.
Barometer. The altitude. 001. That's okay. Our flight plan and read weather. We've done
complete.
The flight plan.
Initial transponder code to 2000. Set.
That's set already.
Active database. Current.
That's fine.
Checked. UTC. Correct. Checked. Database. Ident. Origin ICAO. Then index. Set. Flight plan. Route menu. Co-route list.
Okay,
select
so
and set.
Now it's time to put in the flight plan. So we're going to go here. We've already set that up. Then there. Ignore that. Cool. So we've done that. And now we need to do the departure and arrival. Get up our navigraphs here so we can see where we're going. So we're doing a SODA 9 kilo departure. SODA 9 kilo for 17. 9 kilo. And no transition. The arrival into LTAC is going to be. A Kizzy 1E. To free right. Left. And where are we going via? Okay, I'll do that. There's just got us programmed for the Ankara VOR for a straight in approach, so we're just going to do vectors. Fine. Cool, so we can set up our climb. Pitch. Go to navigraphs and right. Mandalay standard departure. Soda. Sodri. Transition altitude is 5000. Cruise on this flight is going to be 410, that'd be high. start, 1-0. And it landed 2.5. It's fine. So that's okay. Yeah. Lovely, so this is all done.
Anti-collision lights.
So we've got to start
all
up now.
Set. Booster pump 2.
Okay.
On. Set.
Okay.
Press
start
to start 2.
Two.
On. Set. Power lever number 2. To idle when N2 stable.
I don't see the... I don't see the N2 going up, so we might have to... We might have to... Oh.
Set. Visual check N2, ITT, N1, hydraulic pressure.
What's going on here? Turn it off a sec. Trying to figure out what's going on here. We've got gin, that's all on. Just a one. Round. Tired. That oil. Is that not starting? Bear with me a second. I'm just going to try and figure this out. Something is... That's very strange. I think maybe what we might have to do is just start engines to run in from here. It's the only way we're going to get it started, I think. I have no idea why I did that, but apologies, guys. It's obviously something to do with the oil, because I had an oil warning light. How do you get rid of that? I have no idea. Two engines on.
Okay. Check. External power, off removed. Set. Slat system stall 1 test, press.
I do these bits here.
Set. Booster pump 3, on. Set. Press to start 3, on.
Okay, so we've done all that, we've done all that. Let's just go to the next
left
page.
Left and right hand bus, untied vertical. Set. All failure warning lights off, except PTO.
That's fine.
Checked. Transfer pumps 1, 2, 3, on. Check. Hydraulic standby pump. Auto. Check. Cabin pressure controller, rate to 2,000 feet per minute. Set. Cabin pressure controller, barometer QNH. Set. Cabin pressure controller, cabin altitude to cruise altitude. Set. Visual check cabin triple indicator, left hand pilot panel.
Visual check, yeah.
Checked. Yaw dampener, off. Set. Pitch trim stabilizer, 5 degrees set. checked. IRS aligned, then set to NAV. Set. Set assigned transponder code.
Yeah.
Set.
Heading bug.
Heading bug. Aligned to departure runway.
Oh, departure runway. Runway 17. Runway 17.
Set. Flight guidance heading, on. Set. Flight guidance initial altitude.
I don't think we have a... SID chart here. Initial altitude. Let's have a look. A Sodri departure. Read this. Initial climb clearance is 2,000.
FLC set. Flight guidance initial speed.
Okay.
Set. Autopilot, disconnect. Set. Parking brakes, disengage. Set. ATC request pushback, if required. Requested. ATC request taxi.
Okay, requested. So we've got the lights on that we need.
Taxi lights, on. Set. Anti-collision lights, all. Checked. Landing lights, on.
I'm using what's the landing checked. Lights on now?
APU stop, off. Set. APU master, off. Set.
Okay, and let's
transfer
check our...
intercom 1 and 2, untied, vertical.
Set.
Crossfeed 1 and 2, untied, vertical. Set. Autopilot and co-pilot, on.
Cool, so our radio's all set. Get the pitot heat on.
Set. Motor start 1, 2, 3, air, start. Set. Go to holding point and set park brakes.
Okay, so we're ready for taxi. And let's put out a call. Cans traffic, taxi into holding point Alpha 1 for runway 17 via Whiskey. And that's Papa Hotel, Delta Tango, Foxtrot, Cans traffic. So we've done the call and we are free to taxi because there's no one online right now. We're good to go. Oh, we have coverage pretty much in the whole of the way there now. I just had a look on the chart and we've got coverage. This should be good. This should be very, very good. So, let's start the taxi, a little bit of power. Look around. And I'm just gonna spin around here on the spot. So we've got another aircraft here. Taxi out here. Lovely, so we're on our way. And whilst we're taxiing, we can do some of this other stuff. So it wants that down, which is 2. Heading is done. Autopilot disconnect. Flight and bearing source. Mess. Which. Not seeing that. Check it in a minute. FMS. You rotate at about 115 knots. And Alpha 1 here. Alpha 2, but fuck it. to be honest, there's no one here. Cool, so go to the holding point, set brakes.
Set.
We're good.
We're slats down. Plus 20 flaps. Down.
We can skip
power
that,
levers to full. Rotate and take off.
So we're ready for takeoff here. So let's now let people know that we're going onto the runway. Just going to check the area. There's no one coming in, so we're free to. Runway. Cool. Cans traffic lining up runway 17 and it's Papa Hotel Delta Tango Foxtrot. Cans traffic. Get on the runway, get all lined up. I'm just going to check the flaps again. Yep, flaps is fine. We're at flaps 20. Should.
East traffic 106 through zone 4 right.
Instead of doing the heading, we're going to push the nav. I want it to follow the AP as soon. VNAV works in this aircraft. Everything else is good. Okay, so let's go. Cairns traffic, departing runway 17, Sodri 9 kilo departure to Ankara, Turkey. That's Papa Hotel, Delta Tango Foxtrot, Cairns traffic. Lovely, brakes off, full power. And let's get the show on the road. Gear up. Flaps. Autopilot. Bring the throttle down because we don't want to do over 250 under 10,000. I'm not sure why it wants us to be at 2,000 here. So I'm just going to check the navigraphs. Okay, so we should actually be okay to climb out from here, to be honest. I'll do a little call just to let people know that we're clear of the runway. Cairns traffic, clear of runway 17, Papa Hotel, Delta Tango, Foxtrot, Cairns traffic. Okay, so we can set our altitude. I'm just going to go straight up to 410. Go. And I believe the climb is 150 in this. So let's go flight level climb, flight level change, and we need to go. And initially it will look like we're doing a crazy climb, but once the speed settles back down, it should level out about 2,000 feet per minute. I think we should be good to climb from here. Let's just do another call. Cairns traffic, climbing through flight level 100 for 410 via Sodri, Papa Hotel, Delta Tango, Foxtrot. Yeah, so we've let them know we're climbing. Hopefully soon we should get some ATC. Lander gear, your damper. Go on. Flaps is clean, lander gear's up. That's set, motor start.
Checked. Climb speed 130 KIAS. Landing gear, up. Set.
Standard lights.
Flaps clean,
off. Up. Now we're past 10,000.
Set.
Go standard barometer.
Yaw damper, on.
Taxi
set.
Lights can come off.
Autopilot, AP2 on. Set. Motor start 1, 2, 3.
It should be good.
GRD start.
This thing is a rocket ship.
Set.
Oh, there we go. It looks
landing
like it was
lights
down, but it wasn't.
Off. Set. Taxi lights off. Set. Set autopilot to NAV as required by ATC flight plan. Fasten seat belts. Off. Set.
I mean, I wouldn't
altimeter
want to be standing up in the
set
back
1,
right now.
Or 29.92.
The angle this is climbing at is crazy.
Flight displays. Visual check.
About 18,000. That's okay.
Checked. Continue to cruise.
Check everything. outside temperature, you probably want to put anti-ice on. Turn the temperature up a little bit, about 19 degrees, which is efficient. And continue to cruise.
Continue to descent.
And that's okay, we can close this for now. Until we reach descent. Lovely jubby, so we're in the air, we're on our way. And everything's looking good. Just coming up to Dimad, which is still on the departure. I'm hoping by Sodri we should be well up there. Ooh. I think we might just be a little bit unfortunate. Okay, so unfortunately, our flight plan takes us just under the area in which Milano radar covers, and also the next zone along. Also, we're going underneath, but hopefully, once we get to Eurocontrol, which is just after Italy, it's by, where's that, Dubrovnik sort of area, that's where it starts, so we should get coverage over there. We'll see how it goes. What I quickly might do is I don't know what I just touched there, something clicked. But just great looking plane, very loud though, outside. Oh, so we're climbing, we're doing okay. And yeah, so I'll just leave it to climb for now. And we'll check back when we're at 410. Yeah, so I just noticed that we're going off track slightly. I'm not sure what I clicked. I definitely clicked something before, but it somehow managed to put in a vector waypoint. So I'm not sure what happened there. We're just going to come back onto it. I'm just gonna go via Sodri. There we go. Should bring us back on course. Silly me. We'll do as much of this flight as we can, because I'm not overly sure on how long this is going to take, to be honest. Zero, we'll probably get to about Mach 8.2, I believe. It looks like we're starting to speed up now. And we have a 13 knots headwind, I believe. Yeah, 13 knots. That shouldn't cause many problems with aircraft. And I don't think there's one guy at 35,000 off our left wing. One at 37. That guy's still at 37 feet. Max 7.1. This is actually a great aircraft. Many aircraft do like that. Yeah, I'd love to see one that doesn't have these pillars. Pillarless wraparound screen, how cool would that be? Yeah, like, That's the wind on the glass. Oh, yeah. But yeah, you do get like a airliner, old airliner. Great aircraft, this one. I think this was like my second aircraft I bought. It's been a lot of fun to me over the years on Best Economy, but I don't play it. I play FS Charter. I didn't really fill the fuel up in this either a lot. So, pretty good job. We're not going too far. I'm not sure where it's getting those figures from, then that we've used 4,000 pounds already? Can't be much, sure. We've used a lot of fuel. I did say on in brief, we only need 4,000 kilograms. So yeah, I'm not sure what that's about, but hopefully we'll make it. We'll just have to keep an eye on that. Hopefully we won't have to make a stop somewhere, because that'd be tragic. Not sure if we can reduce the burn by much. Not sacrifice any speed. Maybe not a bad idea. think it's going to be a tight one because it says 4-2 something. So it's going to be, we've only got about 2 hours burn time. Says the block time or the air time is 2:40. I don't think the descent is going to be 4 minutes. Not really sure what it's going to do here. Going to have to do. The FS chart, so it says expected fuel level 6.0. So 545 kilograms it's used. That will be my fault though, because I kind of tried to skimp on the fuel. Even though I put about 10,000 kilograms in it on FS Charter. Let me check. Yeah, so I loaded 10,000 kilograms. It says it's used 500 already. Interesting. Just have to wait and see, I guess. That doesn't really do anything, so. I'm just fiddling myself now, I should probably stop. In a minute the plane will drop out of the sky. Oh, those clouds look horrible. Is that like meant to be a heat haze or something? What the hell is that? What is that? to that list there. Half an hour, I wish. We should have enough. Good. Going by these times, that should be. You know, that says 19 minutes. Oh, 19 there. 14, 19. It's going to be close, I think. It's going to be close. Worst case scenario, could do. I mean, we're not flying across much water, so we're okay. LTFM is our alternate. Worst case scenario, we could land at Istanbul. Little tap. We just got to hope for the best, I guess. I'm just going to quickly go back and show you this plane, because I don't think many people have actually seen this, so I'll give you a quick go around. Obviously, this is the ceiling's pretty nice. You get like some nice graphics. These are the avionics, by the way. A lot of people can't find them. Pretty nicely modelled. I mean, it looks authentic. You have these sun visors, use them as well. Cool. I can check it here, I guess. Hang some things in. Open, operate. Nice. Go through the door. I'm gonna pretend Max Verstappen and know all the boys are in here. That closes. You have a nice screen here. What screen? Photo frame. This is obviously all your in-flight food, I believe. Nicely modeled chairs. Comes out here. TVs here that are pretty well modelled. You've got X-Men on here, you've got, can't really tell any of those other ones. Yeah, I can't tell any of those other things. Yeah, these lines work. Oh, Nice. Anything else works? Got this really cool like bench seat thing on the back here that's sideward. And if I'd want to be sitting on that during takeoff, and chillax, beat up. I don't do. I don't think this back bit's modelled. I think that is, but I'm guessing that. The detailing on the body is. You have the gear style ways the modelled. Yeah, no, it's pretty good aircraft. The textures aren't the best, I guess, this paint job. Nice. The best paint job by a community member, but from far it looks okay. You can get some nice views. One of the cool things about this Carronado stuff is you can go flip around the views here, the presets. Radio and FM. That's a bit balked, to be honest. Get a view from the rear, on the left window, pilot, on the overhead panel, which is really handy actually. I don't use this enough. Get a co-pilot from the side. Get a throttle, I'm not sure why it's so zoomed in. You can right window and you can go on the passenger. Some of these views are messed up, I'm not sure where. Maybe it's some of the modifications I've done to this aircraft, plane makers and the port views. Nice view like that, awesome. They're going to be pilots. Disturb them. Quickly show you these on visors. I've never really worked them out. Can you pull them up and down from side to side? That window there, mainly. And then, yes. Yeah, it would be nice if you could put it down over this. Other side. Works on this window here. Yeah, it's pretty good. You have, you know, night lighting's decent. On this aircraft, these here. I usually just have these off because they seem to affect the FPS pretty bad. Oh, that's it. Yeah. Than that, we're chilling at cruise now. We're just went over Italy by the looks of it. Here's the Italian controllers have gone offline. Way into Euro control. Past it. We have this autopilot pop out control used, which is pretty nice. And yeah, you have indoor reflection. It doesn't really add a reflection, it dims it down a little bit, I'm not sure. So, something like that. See this instrument reflection here. winglets, ground power on the main door, and obviously static elements, so we can't do it. You're in flight. And we'll just enjoy the cruise. So quickly check navigraphs. I believe once we hit retro, maybe a little bit before actually. Maybe even Catty, just after Catty, that's when we should the control contact us. So we waypoints, Catty. Bow. 3 minutes, have some control. They don't log off, that is. It's generally, that always happens to me on a flight. Have control, and I get just with them, or, you know, just before, and then they log off. They see me coming. This is all good flying because I'm trying to get my business jet type rating up on FS Charter. And if we have a look, so we're at 95 hours, level 6. Over 25 hours. So these longish kind of flights, I don't usually do like 3 hour long flights in biz jets. I usually do like 1-2 hour hops. But yeah, it's all going to be good for the hours, eventually the pay. It'll be interesting when we get to we get to some of the bigger hops, because this isn't that far, to be honest. When you're going from like, have a look at the dates. Have a look at it. So we're going Bahrain, which we're going now, then we're going to go Saudi Arabia, which isn't a bad hop at all, that's quite short as well, and then we're going to do Saudi Arabia, now that is a pretty long hop, that Saudi Arabia to wow. Need to get unscarved. Bad idea to do. Map. So Jeddah is on the other side of Saudi Arabia, so we go from Bahrain, Jeddah, where from about the same distance from maybe Iraq. We're gonna land in Iraq. Riyadh. Then we're gonna do Saudi Arabia about three times as far as we're doing Cannes to Saudi, from Cannes to Bahrain, about times that distance. For that, I take But, hey, we're in it for the long run now, so you gotta do it. Say we're going to National One. Say we're going to the International One. That is going to be a total of 6,900 nautical miles, and in a Falcon, which I don't think that can actually do that range, it might have to be two hops. It's going to be 7 hours each. 7 hours in two hops, or 14 hours in total. I can't imagine he would do that though. I'm sure he will go like via Japan or something, or Male. I'm sure he will go via like Male or something. Male and then like Thailand, I don't know. We'll have to see. We're going to do whatever route he does. So. He does a long haul, and then we're going to be doing a long haul. He does short. Few short ones, which I can't imagine he will be doing. The only places you can stop there are going to be like India, China. Then China or Japan or something. Indonesia, Malaysia, something. I don't know. The only way there, really, about doing a long haul, so. We'll see. It'll be good either way. Coming across Atchock. In about 15 minutes we Honestly, I probably should have done this as a stream, because I don't think anyone's going to sit and watch a 7-hour YouTube video on the Australia Hop, but, you know, it is what it is. And that's going to take one hell of a time to upload as well. Should have definitely been a stream. Because then I could do like a 7-hour overnight hop on the Friday or something, and then 7 hours on the Saturday or something. Oh well. That's the thing, after Australia, then you got Azerbaijan. So that's the thing, once you've done Azerbaijan, you've got another 14 hour trip back up to Azerbaijan, which is above Iraq. Honestly, this they should go like, you know, it should, I don't know why they start in Bahrain, honestly. But they should try and reroute it a bit better, so it's a bit more flowing. Then yeah, you got another 14-hour hop back, and after that, Azerbaijan. You're going to Miami. Good fair few hours. No, like 14, 15, 16 hour trip. And then back to Italy. No? So they're flying over the place that they're going to next, on Miami, then back to Italy. Then they're going to go to Monaco. So they go Italy, then to Monaco, Europe. Spain, which isn't too bad down there. Then back to Canada. Then they go to Montreal, I believe. Is it? Then back to US. Canada. And then back to Europe. Back to Austria. Then into Austria, when they could have done that like after, you know, Italy or something. And then to UK, Silverstone, and then they go to Hungary, Belgium, which they could do after or before, UK, Netherlands, they could also do on the way to Belgium or something. Then back to Italy. Back to Italy again. And then to Singapore. Back to Singapore. Down here. Malaysia. And then to Japan. To Qatar. Fucking hell, mate, they use so much fuel for nothing. So much wasted time going back and forth. Qatar and then Qatar, USA. Oh, USA. Then USA to Mexico, which isn't too bad. Mexico to Peru. Brazil. Brazil, back to fucking Las Vegas, and then Abu Dhabi. This is the last, so then you're gonna go from the last way back over. What the hell? Their schedule. They should do a tour of, like, I don't know. Obviously, it's probably not that interesting for the viewer. How they're gonna like tour like Middle East or Europe or like China, like in the Oceania down in Australia and stuff, and then tour America all in one. But surely it would make sense to like. Surely. So most of the teams are coming from like Europe, aren't they? Surely. They're coming from like near Europe. So if you start in Europe, will you like do a couple around Europe and head out, do Saudi, go into China, down to Australia, then from Australia just go all the way to Brazil or something and go up. Surely that's got to be. I mean, I'm no logistics expert. Okay. Maybe I have to ask DHL how much fuel they use. That'd be interesting. How are we doing here? 7 minutes. See where we are on Navigraphs. Yeah, I don't think we're gonna have enough fuel, honestly. Let's see how much fuel we've used. Oh. Been in the air an hour and we've used, let's just see how much. Apparently we've loaded 10,000 fuel and we've used 800, almost 10%. The fuel burn is wrong. If we use 10%, we should have more than enough, but this says, according to this, we're going to be burning most of our fuel in the next hour. We've been up an hour and used 10%. Charts quickly. Aircraft performance tables. So it says 0.75 Mach cruise. Wait. Say we're 34, 32,000, 34. just go for a middle number or something. We should be cruising at 90%. And apparently this says fuel burn is worse than what we're getting right now. I can't do that. Something's not right with this aircraft. We're cruising at 90% and we're getting 433 when we should be at like 500 fuel flow. But yeah, we definitely didn't put nothing. Like, retro is about halfway, I would say. Retro. And we're going to be there in 22 minutes. So if we're burning 431, I don't know what we started off with actually. About 900. We need to be there like pretty soon. Pretty damn soon. 20 minutes. We need to be halfway. I have a feeling we might just be okay. We might be. I just don't understand why this fuel used is saying that. See how much we get to about 150. How much we get? And try and work out how much distance is left. If we do it on 3.3, that'll give us the measurement. Almost there. So that will give us 150 nautical miles worth once we get to retro. And once we're retro, we can kind of decide, I think. It says here, descent, we need to start descending at Herc. So our descent doesn't start until really late. I'm not sure what's going on actually. According to the fuel flow, right now we have about an hour and a quarter. Times that by two, that's about an hour. So that's the only thing we can really do is reduce the speed slightly, which may give us a better cruise. Okay, so let's see where we're at now. And how far we need to go? Retro. Use 81. 500 left. 300 per hour. Really could do with a power wing. Now I've reduced the... Just be okay. We might just be okay. We'll be very tired though, that's for sure. So a retro is about halfway out. Just an airport. Ooh. Control. Let's do a call out. Let's have a Euro Control, with you at flight level 410, inbound Retro, Papa Hotel, Delta Tango, Foxtrot.
Papa Hotel, Delta Tango, Foxtrot, good evening, Euro Control, this is set squawk 0225.
0225 Delta, sorry, Papa Hotel Delta Tango Foxtrot. Okay, there we go. And that is a shame, Turkey has gone offline. At least we're in a zone now.
with 1551, monitor Unicom 122.8, have a nice flight, goodbye. Papa Tango Foxtrot, radar contact, proceed direct Foxtrot Sierra Kilo.
Proceed direct Foxtrot Sierra Kilo, Papa Hotel Delta Tango Foxtrot. So we're going to be going direct. Maybe that will help us save a bit of fuel. Not too. That doesn't really do us any favours, but. Passing retro now.
Lot 6 Bravo Lima, hello Eurocontrol, set squawk 0256.
Control is good evening, Ryanair 8, call flight level 250, climbing flight level 370. We are direct demo from the north here.
Ryanair 8,
Golf
Eurocontrol, Isk, set squawk 0271.
Squawk 0271, Ryanair 8.
Turkish 1506, monitor Unicom 122.8, goodbye.
122.8, goodbye, Turkish 1506.
Ryanair 8 Golf radar contact, proceed direct Parak, climb flight level 370.
Climb flight level 370, direct Parak,
Ryanair 8 Golf, after Parak, proceed direct Maket.
And after Parak, we will proceed direct Maket, so Ryanair 8 Golf.
control is Ryanair 567, back Foxtrot, ready for the control.
Ryanair 56, Quebec Foxtrot, descend fly level 230, proceed direct Baffman.
230, direct to Baffman, thank you. Ryanair 56, Quebec Foxtrot.
Euro Control, good evening. Turkish 51, November Golf, that level 290, sorry for the late contact.
Turkish 51 November Golf, good evening, Eurocontrol East Radar contact. Proceed direct Auschwitz, climb flight level 340.
Direct Auschwitz and flight level 340, Turkish 51 November Golf.
Wizard 100 Uniform, monitor Unicom 1-2.8, have a nice flight, goodbye.
I don't actually know where we are right now. Let's quickly have a look. Yeah, I'm not too sure. Okay, we're just over Albania right now. My gosh, we've gone so far.
Ryanair 38 Sierra Tango, good evening, Eurocontrol East, radar contact. Proceed direct Ogdav.
And I don't think I'm going to skimp on the next trip. The problem is I'm flying on FS Charter, and when you do a one-off job, which it's an unpaid job basically, you have to fill the fuel before you accept the job. Well, before you can even see Simbrief to see how much fuel you need. So it's a bit of a wild guess, and I put 10,000 in because on the last flight that I did, I filled it to full and the aeroplane wouldn't take off, like it wouldn't lift at its normal takeoff, like maximum takeoff weight, takeoff speed, sorry. So I reduced the fuel and it took off nicely this time.
That's 544, go ahead.
Unfortunately, we're a little bit short. Also, on FS Charter, I am using a Falcon 7X, which has more fuel capacity and also longer range. Whereas this one is a Falcon 50, the model in the sim that I'm using, so has about half the amount of fuel. And yeah, it's not great. And the range is about the same, I believe. I think the fuel burn is worse in the Falcon 50. But we're gonna send it, I think we might we'll make it. We should be okay. Cause descending from 410, if we have a look on the program, how long have we got? So to top of descent, we have 41 minutes. We have enough fuel to burn for over an hour. So really, there's no reason why we shouldn't make it. We have an hour and 20 minutes to the destination. But about 40 minutes of that is going to be a descent. Hopefully, we should be able to make it. We should be okay. I'm going to send it anyway. If not, I'll have to, I don't know. I'll have to find an airport nearby this. Let me have a look on the map, just so we have a plan. Because where we're going is quite mountainous, and there's not that many airports.
Ryanair 56 Quebec Foxtrot Monitor Unicom 122.8, goodbye.
Unicom Ryanair 56 Quebec Foxtrot, thank you, good night.
So we're over North Macedonia right now. We should be exiting this guy's airspace shortly, so we'll listen for a call.
Ryanair 380 Tango, roger, descend flight level 230. Ryanair 56 Quebec Foxtrot, monitor Unicom 122, simulate, have a nice landing, goodbye. Papa Tango Foxtrot, monitor Unicom 122.8, goodbye.
122.8, have a good night, Daniel, thank you. Papa Tango Foxtrot. There we go, so. Back to Unicom. I mean, there's no one really around us right now, but I mean, I didn't think Ankara was a big place, but it looks like a lot of people are taking off from there, so. And there's been a few flights, well, there's one coming in, one going out right now. So looks like quite a busy airport, I imagine. Continue with the flight. Okay, let's hope now we got the wind behind us a little bit. It'll push us on. Yeah, man. I'm sure that just said 30 minutes to top of descent. I'm gonna look at the route and see if there's any way. There's no way we can save any time, really. I don't know how this is gonna work. Because we have 350 and we got 330. We got about an hour worth of flight left. 20 minutes. Might be okay. Keep saying it, I'm just worrying so much. We're gonna have 20 minutes of fuel in the descent. We may just have to go straight in. I don't know. I don't know what we're gonna do. This is so tight. So tight. If we make this, this is a miracle. If not, I don't want to bail. I don't want to bail the flight. Because we could bail at Istanbul. But they had tower online. could bail like before then, after then as well, but I'm hoping once we get to Gayen, it's going to be a nice descent down. We can reduce the throttle. Can't be right. It's more than that. 16 minutes to go. This is so tight. Why is that not going down? Why isn't this 50 knots wind behind us helping us? That's what I don't understand. The it says fuel consumed 1.3 tons, expected fuel level 5.7 tons. Should be 6-7 tons of fuel total, and we've consumed I still have to work out the descent profile. It's probably going to be 1500 feet per minute. We don't want to come in too steep, but we don't want to come in too shallow as well. We still got a distance of like Farnborough to Lowy left. Maybe even longer. mean, what might not be a bad idea is to go just fly for an hour at 41,000 and then do the descent in like 10 minutes and use the very steep descent. We have like exactly an hour's worth of fuel. Better start looking up emergency procedures. Whoosh! Not good for the first flight. Oh god. Emergency procedures. Yeah, so there's nothing about it out of fuel there. I think we just gotta send it, honestly. Might just edit the flight plan slightly because we don't really need to go to BKZ. Let me just edit it a little bit. Eggs. We got discontinuity in there as well. else can we get rid of? Let's see, we can get rid of Gaim and Urkel as well. If we got a program. May have saved us some time, who knows? Let's try and get the charts up. Oh yeah, there isn't. Oh yeah, there is somewhere. Hold on. Kizik 1E. So it doesn't actually give us any altitudes either in this arrival. We could keep the descent pretty shallow. Come in high and then at the last minute. Or we just keep flying high. Fuel runs out and then glide it in. It's more of a risk. It's a tough call. I wouldn't like to be in this position in real life. That's for sure. To the top of the sun. Any air-to-air refuelers about? Come and top me up. Just a little bit. I really hope we make it. I really, really, really hope. Yeah, I'm even going to turn the smoking lights off just so people can have a fag. Oh no, we got Max Verstappen on board. Max 7660 knot tailwind, and it's not even helping us. Do you reckon I could put like 100 knot tailwind on or something? It'll just like push us there. The thing is, once you're descending, you can reduce the throttle, you know? Makes it so much easier. Still got like an hour until we land. We're 40 minutes in descent, I suppose. Like in this aircraft, do you think you could turn one engine off in the middle, cross-feed the tanks, so you have like a little bit more, and then, so like right now we could cross-feed the middle and get like 330, and that'd give us an hour, which is enough to get there. But would we get max 7.7 still, or we'd probably have to put the fuel flow up? I don't know if that would be a thing. Reduced the throttle a little bit, now we got a wind behind us. Save some fuel. About 40 minutes fuel left, and we got about 52 minutes to come. Just so nerve-wracking. 10 minutes. The wind's picking up as well, so hopefully that helps us a little bit. There's 63 knots tailwind now. Yeah, it's just a waiting game now. That's all we have to do, is wait 10 minutes. Start the descent and then we find out if we can make it. Yeah, I'm not too sure. I'm reading some stuff about cutting an engine on descent, but I don't. Not too sure. Okay, so we're 5 minutes to descend, and we have... seems to be about a half an hour of fuel left at this current. Come on. We can do this. I know we can. Oh gosh, I have a lot of aircraft below me. It's because I'm coming past Istanbul. On the left, down there somewhere. It's prep for descent. Try and do actually is start the descent now and do it at 1,000 feet per minute. Thing is, we don't want to go too low. But maybe bring that up a little bit. Doesn't look like the fuel burn's gonna help. Ankara traffic descended through flight level 370 for 100, inbound Numza. It's Papa Hotel, Delta Tango Foxtrot. There's a chance that this descent might save us. Because we've got 156 on board, which means, and we got 36 minutes to our destination, and we can burn fuel in the descent at almost twice the rate. But I'm going to stick to 250. And I hope that this gets us to our destination. We should be okay. I can feel it. I'm just gonna believe. We have to do. A storm up ahead. Oh, please don't tell me we've got a storm as well. Hopefully we're going to turn away from that. Come on. Believe. We're at 31,000. I would say 1,500 is much. We have 33 minutes to go. We're at 30,000 feet. We're gonna come in a bit too low, I believe, if that's correct. I'm just gonna go max throttle for a sec, see how much it uses. That is the airport straight in front of us, though. Come on, we can do this, now, mate. This is gonna be so tight. Maybe the one engine will run out before. Or the other two as well. I believe we do need to enter the approach of the ball. 03 right. Needs the frequency is 110.3. Sorry, I'm not speaking much, I'm just trying to concentrate. This is, you know, light stuff for them with it. When I see the runway, then I'll be happy and know that we're going to get there. No way. The airport is down here somewhere. Yeah, that's the airport. Let's go, let's go, let's go. Come on, dude. We got this. I think we got it. We're gonna have one engine shut down shortly as well. That's the airport there. And we're going to overshoot it, I think, actually.
Caution.
We're going to do a manual descent. Running to way too fast.
Bank angle, 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 bank angle,
sink rate,
bank angle,
sink rate,
bank angle, bank angle,
sink rate, sink rate, sink rate, sink rate,
bank angle, bank angle, bank angle, bank angle, bank angle, bank angle, bank angle.
Sink rate, sink rate.
Gear.
Sink rate, sink rate.
Gear.
Sink rate, sink rate.
Gear.
Sink rate,
gear.
Sink rate.
Gear.
Sink rate, sink rate. 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 Sink rate, sink rate.
Minimum.
Pull up. Pull up. Sink rate, sink rate.
100, 50, 40, 30, 20, 10, 10.
Hey, not the best landing. Not the best flight. I know. But most importantly, we made it. And we didn't run out of fuel. Oh, wait, there we did. Yeah. And we'll just try and cruise to the parking. We run out on the taxi there, maybe. They still have one engine, two engines. So I'm just going to go over there to what looks like a executive sort. That's where we're going to pop up. Hey. There we go, we made it with how much? 14 in one side, 20 in one engine out. And welcome to Ankara. Thank you. Dark and soak in the door. Level. And let me put the elements in for measure. Okay, so we're all powered down, and that's the end of the flight. So thanks for watching, guys, and yeah, I'll see you on the next legs. We're gonna do Turkey, Ankara to Al Basra in Iraq. So yep, that shouldn't be a too long of a hop. Having a look at the map quickly. Be that long of a hop. Yeah, hopefully we can get that done, and we'll be at Bahrain tomorrow. Thanks for watching, and tune in for the next leg. And see you next time.